Okay, so those are the default ones. There's more stuff in there that I want than what I want. So what we did was I edited those queries to, and I'll just show you this one here. To basically prune it down to only have the stuff that I'm interested in. So I took out the columns by editing the query. You just basically, instead of just saying, give me all the columns, you explicitly state the ones that you want. For instance, I just want the unit ID. I just want the timestamp of the value, the region state, just the stuff I'm going to use in my report. Okay. And the same I did for the snapshot one. Now, if you were to take a look at what these look like, and one of the other features of SQL Commander, which I think is important for PowerPivot, is that you can give these queries a name so people who are using PowerPivot don't have to ever see the queries. And those name queries, or the way you save them with a name, is through something called a view. So in SQL Commander, there is this section called Views. In fact, you'll notice that every one of these areas has a view. You can put views in any one you want. It doesn't really matter. It'd probably almost be easier to have just one view, but we have a bunch of different places, so you can take your pick. They all work exactly the same. I've created several views here. So the main thing that you have to be able to do is take, you're going to get this by default look pretty much like this, but there are things you have to edit, like what start time and end time do you want, so what time range do you want the data for. You'll notice off to the right there where it says time step, I want to pick it up in an hour instead of 30 minutes, so you just have to edit it basically, what it amounts to. The other thing is, at the top, this is going to come out and say, I want to give you all the columns. So it's just going to say TC star. You can see up there in the select statement, I basically put TC.time, TC.generation efficiency. And those names are just the names of your attribute or AF model. So you pick and choose which ones you want. Then you save this view. And now what happens is when we go to PowerPivot, you'll see in a minute, to bring this data in, we're just going to check the box near the views that we want, and it'll go ahead and bring the data in. We won't have to worry about what the query looks like. So this is the hardest part of the whole thing because it's new to most people, and a lot of people don't deal with this kind of thing.